Welcome to Access a Trader, the number one community for those who are committed to taking control of their trading in order to achieve success, profitability, and longevity. Thank you for joining us. Here's Dan Shapiro to help you find your edge, master your process, and own your future.
Hey guys, good evening everybody. Welcome to another edition of the AccessToTrader.com nightly wrap-up show. Hope everybody is doing well. If it sounds like I'm screaming, I don't know if I am. For some reason, I got something stuck in my ear, and I've been trying to get it out all afternoon. So if it sounds like I'm screaming, I apologize. I have to take a hot shower to clear out my ear later. So hopefully everybody is doing well. Just a quick little announcement. This coming up Saturday, a lot of people always ask me, what's the dimensions of the live webinar? I would say 55-45, either direction, equity versus options. This Saturday, May the 11th at 10 a.m., okay? Kind of save the day for all you guys. There is going to be a five-trader panel that are going to go answer all your questions for all you guys who are interested in trading options or do trade options via the pivots. They're very, very kind enough to allocate their time. Again, as everybody knows, I am the most complete novice when it comes to trading. As far as options goes, I'm an equities guy, but they do trade pivots via the PS60 theory, and they will show you how. All these gentlemen are within different stages of their career in trading as far as experience, but they're very gracious to allocate their time. So this Saturday for all you guys in the Access a Trader family, it will be available to you. And if you can't make it, okay, it will be recorded. So just kind of a heads up. So let's talk about today. So yesterday on the weekend video, okay, the extended weekend video, we talked about two scenarios. We talked about the Qs really reclaiming the five-day moving average, which was super, super bullish. But at the same time, we talked about over the weekend how many names, right, the big high flyers were really coming down and showing a lot of weakness. And again, you could have easily made the case, well, stocks don't go straight up, these stocks are just resting. Or you can make easily the case that, well, people just don't want to chase hot money anymore and starting to be a little bit cautious. And today was a perfect example of you could be both right, right? You could be absolutely right with your theory. You could be absolutely right with your bias. You could be absolutely right with both cases of the scenario. Sometimes you could just actually be right. And that today is a perfect example of that. And the way we started watching the market, especially towards the end of last week, we saw them guessing out. You know, we talked about on the weekend video how Amazon was setting up to the downside, how Netflix last week started breaking below the 450 area on the five-day moving average, how important that level was. We talked about how names like ZM, like BYND had their big runs, right? Had their majestical big runs, and they were just very just a day away from kind of giving it all back. And today was a perfect example why indexes mean absolutely nothing. We've been saying this for years. It doesn't make a difference. The market could be up 10,000 points of the day, 3,000 points of the day. As long as your process is being highlighted, you have a puncher's chance. And that's all we ask for as traders, just have a puncher's chance. And when you look at the final numbers today, and again, big, big futures gap up in the last couple of days. Yesterday we were closed celebrating the Memorial Day holiday, but the futures were surging because you started seeing a lot of news come out that there are soft tentative date for June the 15th for all the, you know, mom and pop non-essential businesses that were closed through this whole time and really, really suffering. They're going to start to open up. And the market is, again, just fueling, more fuel to the fire, more gasoline to the bull case. And again, it's very, very tough to be a bear, a long-term bear, when you have the prospects of a global, right, global reopening all year round for the rest of this year. And again, what happens next for a possible second wave of corona, that's a whole different story. Again, cross our fingers. Hopefully it won't escalate again. But for the case of trading, right? That's exactly what fueled to the fire. The problem was most of these names were gapping right into supply. Okay, a lot of these names were, you saw Amazon gapping to supply. You saw the Qs. You could clearly tell where Qs got rejected. They got rejected right into supply. Tesla, I thought today was definitely going to be the day for Tesla. Again, came right back in. Netflix kept on confirming down. Roku, Beyond. And you started seeing what we talked about last week, that the market, again, is not going to tap you on the shoulder and say, hey, by the way, we're going to pull the rug. They're going to pull the rug. And if you look at the scoreboard today, the final numbers, they don't paint a picture at all. Because if you asked me today if the market was up or the market was down, I would tell you the market was down. Because again, if you look at the Dow Jones Industrial, you're talking about only 30 stocks, right? Up 500 points. They're up, I think, as much as 700 points, a 1.2% move. And if you look at the Qs, we were red, right? We were absolutely red. And this is the proxy where I look at strength and weakness in the market. Again, it's not really that hard to get the market moving up, you know, right? With especially with these Dow stocks, you know, Boeing, right? You got a $7 move on Boeing. You got Deere, right? You got Deere, you got Caterpillar. I mean, how hard is it, you know, how hard is it to get the Dow Jones up 300, 400, 500, 600, 700 points? And that's kind of the whole point. Very, very deceiving. The news outlets were going to, and I'm sure they still are going to highlight how strong the market is. If you look at the Qs today, very, very aggressive rug pull, right? Right from the time they opened up, they hit supply and yada, yada, yada. Again, big, big sell-off. Into the close. And again, it's very, very hard for me to turn around going into tomorrow's session saying, well, I'm very, very bullish on this. Okay. If somebody could show me a bullish chart, especially in the beta world, I will be more than happy to look at it. But if you look at what the market actually did today, when I mean the market, the QQQs, you see again, here's my point of market leaders got tired, put in their blow-off stop. Again, as soon as they confirmed the five-day moving average, you can go through all these beta names, you'll see exactly the same thing. Amazon confirmed the five-day moving average. We talked about this. Big, big move down. Again, you can just see them one by one. We talked about Zoom. We talked about BYND setting up. Nice move today on BYND. Still love BYND for tomorrow to the downside. NVIDIA looks like it's like one day away from gassing out. You see this, guys? One day away from gassing out. You got Apple turning around, another one day away from confirming the five-day moving average. You got Netflix, again, confirmed the five-day off that 450 pivot last week. Again, looks like a magnet, right? Looks like a magnet here to this 407, 408 level for tomorrow's session as well. Even Facebook, they had this really, really ridiculous run, big inverted hammer. Again, if it starts taking out this level here, it should test this rising five-day moving average as well. So it's very, very simple to kind of, you know, have a naive mind and just keep on listening to media, how strong something is, or how impressive something is, or how explosive something is. But if you look at how the market rallied today, and again, there's nothing wrong with a big macro rally, especially stocks that got punished, right? So the financials did very, very well. Citibank, Bank of America, American Express, right, did very, very well. You had your tractor supply companies, your Deere, your Caterpillars did incredibly well as well. Airlines, right, everything's opening up. Cruise ships, everything is opening up. Disney resorts, everything is opening up. But again, we don't trade everything, okay? You're a professional trader. There's no way you can get value in 8,500 stocks. You have to trade the stocks that are in front of you. And we saw it coming. We kind of saw it coming towards the end of last week, how these beta names were getting tired one by one. We looked at the 5-day, we saw them get pulled one by one. And the moral of the story is, again, it's all about your individual process. And again, what's saying to me tomorrow is, unless something miraculously happens in the beta world, how can you turn around and make a case we're going higher tomorrow? But again, as this George Costanza market is, and as I just kind of like joked around on Twitter, I said, look, I'm literally 100% sell biased going into tomorrow. So logically, with this George Costanza market, the money flow will come back in all these stocks and everything will be at all-time high. So obviously, take everything that we think is going to happen for tomorrow's session with a lot of grain of salt. But again, you have to have an opinion, you have to have a bias, you have to have a plan. And now again, it's not about being right, it's about, you know, confirming what our research is telling us for tomorrow's session. So if you look at the pivots today, right, you'll see there was literally one name that confirmed to the upside. Literally, all the value today was to the downside. We started going one by one by one. So here it is. Boeing, I like those pre-market highs, 47.5, 148. Never got there, right? Obviously. Tesla, 835, huge area, pre-market high. Never got there, right? So we're sitting there and you're like, well, listen, you know, if something doesn't go up, it must go down. And this is kind of where sometimes common sense really raises his hand and say, look at me, look at me, look at me. And that's exactly how everything played out. Everything got stuffed. Most of these names got stuffed at 60-minute supply, and you just started seeing them turn over one by one by one. Again, Netflix continues to be just a destruction in price per share. 450 again last week was the monster pivot. And today we talked about 427, held twice daily support. If the market comes in, again, when the market was up 650 points, if the market comes in, it's a big level to confirm to the downside. Netflix got killed, absolutely killed. So here was 427, right? Here was the low here, 427, the low here, 427. It gapped up today, right? Broke the 427 and went down to it went all the way down to 413. I still think there's a shot it goes to 407, 408 for tomorrow. So Netflix got destroyed. I really like this NOW on the long side. Again, never got up there. Again, that's kind of the theme that played out today. Just never got up there. I like NVIDIA to the upside. 369 rejected three times pre-market. Needs to build. NVIDIA came nowhere near 369. Again, we started seeing things getting slower and slower. Less gas for the upside for the bulls. And again, common sense. Whatever doesn't go up must go down. ZM got hit pretty nicely. I took this trade. Caught about $1.50, $1.60 on my runner, which was fine. 168.20, 168. If it builds below, can flush. Actually, the second entry was 67. I was waiting for that second entry. So, beautiful trade. It came back down, confirmed lower when actually as low as the 64. So again, all the higher flyer names that really did well with the stay-at-home movement, those are the ones that got hit. NVAX, pretty aggressive move down. NVAX held 52 twice. If it builds below, can flush, experienced traders only. Here was NVAX, right? Here was the 52, right? Here was the 52, just got destroyed, went down to under 47. Again, you can see value over and over and over again to the downside. Again, perfect example, Amazon, 24.70, huge supply to the upside, needs to reclaim. Didn't come close, didn't even come close to anywhere to the 24.70. So again, we started looking back to the downside, and you'll see the pivot there in a second. Netflix destroyed. BYND, again, we'll talk about Amazon in a second. BYND, green to red, on watch. Note, this is not a pivot, just momentum. It needs to build 134, and Beyond got wrecked, and I still like Beyond for tomorrow, okay? BYND got, you know, took out that 34, went green to red, took out the 34, went down to the 3150 area. I think there's a shot in the next couple of days if the market especially pulls in. There's a shot it gets to 125, so I still like this trade here for tomorrow as well. Roku, again, Roku didn't go down a lot. 108.30, 108, went literally down to like 107.30s. It actually held up for one day, but again, the stock has gotten beaten up pretty aggressively. Beautiful pivot on ZM. Roku, again, only went down like 70 cents or so, but there was actually a pivot to the upside of Roku. 110, here's kind of what I was looking at just to give you guys an example. So this whole channel here was 110.50, right? 110.50, 110.50, 110.50, 110.50. Again, you guessed it, 110.50. And I said, look, if this thing, you know, keeps on getting rejected at 110.50, it needs to build. And here was actually one of the very few pivots to the upside today. So here was 110.50, right? 110.50 here, and it spiked right almost to 112. So nice little spike there on Roku. Amazon went perfectly. 24.40, if it builds below, can flush, right? So here was Amazon. Here's the 24.40, right? Here's the 24.40. It broke the 24.40, went all the way down. And you can see here, it went all the way down to this 24.13 level. I still like Amazon for tomorrow as well. Again, take on the way down. Take on the way up. Beyond, again, 134.45, key level went all the way down to 31.5. And again, this little stock, and actually not little, but VTIQ, again, that's what we say all the time. You don't need to trade beta to trade pivots. VTIQ had nothing to do with beta. VTIQ 28 needs a new base to spike. Here was VTIQ. Strong move on VTIQ. Here was the VTIQ pivot right over here. Here's the whole 28 area, and it spiked to 29.64. Nice move there. Take on the way up. F yeah, that's right. F yeah. Pump on Citron never got there. Boeing 145 went to like 145.70s. Not a big move. Tesla never got up there. I said here, look, take on the way down. Friday's low is 24.30. Could get to 24.21. It got to 24.13. And yeah, here's the 24 on deck. Blah, 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 blah. Waking up. BYND is getting smacked, yada, yada, yada. So, look, there was good value today, definitely good value today. I think tomorrow, again, unless something dramatically changes, I personally am sell biased for tomorrow. If we get a gap up, that would be fantastic. If you look at the Qs, look, I think the Qs, if they start losing this 5 day again, right? Around, you know, 28.70s, 228.70s, I think you get a pull all the way back down to the 27.50. And if 27.50 confirms, you can see a move down to the 26 area. So guys, hopefully everybody is doing well. I'm gonna go take care of my ear. Again, if I was screaming through this, I apologize. Again, I can't hear from one ear. Guys, have a great night, everybody. God bless, and I'll see you on the field tomorrow. Take care, guys.
Congratulations for putting in the time to take control of your trading. You're one step closer to owning your future and achieving the success you desire. Want daily trade ideas directly from Dan, straight off his personal watch list? Unlock our free PS60 Vault, where you'll get nightly updates on pivot opportunities we're watching for the next day's session. Click the link in the description to get started today.